The night land stop recording button.
Thank you.
MM survival explicit. Video player heading. Video player playing advertisement.
Whoever said reality can't be the anticipation.
Video play progress altered. Video play progress at middle dock 46%. MM serve expand this 103,000,000 to.
Fucking ass.
Video player. Video is low.
Sounds weird. Hello, folks. This is Blind Adam, the comic pimp, with another edition of the Awesome Sauce Comics podcast. Don't know what's wrong with my voice today, so you're just going to have to bear with me.
Replay. 0%.
I don't want to replay it, you jackass.
App switcher. Home. 0%. Home. 0%.
Fuck you, too, man. Fuck you. I'm going to play one more song. I'm going to go get some water. And we're going to try to figure out what's wrong with my lyrics. As we test up. I can't get the... Yeah. There may be no catchphrase. This may be an Awesome Sauce Comics podcast first. There may be no high-pitched catchphrases. Aw. Alright, but I'm going to play Kid Rock's Cowboy, and then I'll be right back. And of course it doesn't want to work. We need, bro. We just need some water. I like to find how he flies, too. I got questions for her. Awesome. So, take a sip of water and try it. There's a glass. You drink the glass. You take a sip. Make sure you don't choke. Just like you're choking with this episode. In fact, you need to cheese it. Cheese it by Nabisco crackers and shit, yo. A handful of the cheeses, right, Dave? What you do is put cheeses in your fucking mouth. Finally. Awesome Sauce! He doesn't have the energy I normally have. But... watch this before we start talking to anyone else. Yeah. Thank you. Hello, folks. Like I said, once again, this is Blind Adam, the comic pimp, coming for you live and living color, if you will. On the Awesome Sauce Comic Studios in lovely suburban West Milford, New Jersey, for just a little while longer. You know, always rocking Scores hat, Scores Gentlemen's Club, the greatest gentlemen's club on God's green earth. Or at least they're number one in the top five. West 28th Street, between 10th and 11th Avenues in New York City. The best gentlemen's club in New York City, New Jersey, Connecticut. Well, doesn't beat the Foxy Lady up in Rhode Island and North Attleboro, Massachusetts, but, you know, but in New York City, it's king. ScoresNY.com for all your lap dance needs, all your bachelor party, bachelorette parties. As long as you're 18, you can throw a, and everyone in your party's 18, you can throw a high school graduation party, a senior prom party, as long as everyone's 18. You know, divorce party. Scores is good for every occasion known to mankind. If you need to celebrate, you can celebrate at Scores, New York, the greatest students club of guys we know. Green Earth and the official gentleman's club of the Awesome Sauce Comics podcast. 201 scoresny.com. Tell them Blind Adam sent you. Well, everyone, the reason my voice is so messed up, and the reason you haven't had an episode since last Wednesday, is because I was at New York Comic Con. New York Comic Con was. I'm going to take a sip of water because my voice is still hoarse for some reason. Awesome Sauce! Crap. By the end of this episode, it will be done. We will get the normal pitch that we need. I got a box of Cheez-Its, I got water. I'm gonna flip the Scores hat. The other side, because it's irritating me for some reason right now. But New York Comic Con was insane this year. We officially become San Diego East. Thursday was off the chain. There's the awesome dog. It's barking out of the flyer, so I got. But Thursday was the busiest Thursday that I've seen. Crazy dog. A very, very, very long time. You know, it was great. I got lots of interviews and sound clips for the show, which I'll be playing out for the next few days, because there's just so much. I'm not going to be able to fit it into one episode. So I'm going to break it up to a couple bites, and throughout the rest of this week, I'll play all my New York Comic Con footage. As long as I'm going to get some things off my chest, got a couple what really grinds my gears coming up, and I'm not trying to have Anthony Hammock of Comics Heating Up on at the end of the week, hopefully, and as well as I'm setting up some new interviews, getting some new things done. First, I'm going to let you know, for every of those who could not make the awesomeness and the amazement at the Javits Center last week at New York Comic Con, about a smaller. Matthew and Carl, Jackie, what are you doing? more peaceful, more relaxing comic book convention coming up in the New York City area, December 5th and 6th. Didn't I tell you respect the fucking batteries? Just respect the life of the battery, or the battery will not help you in your time of need. Now play that shit. And here to talk about WinterCon New York is my good friend, Miss Silver. Take it away, Miss Silver. Sounds better on the recording than it does in real life. What's up? What's up with that? I need a tissue. So yeah, that's put away Mr. Hat. We all know they go to scores. The British Gentleman Club of all time. Take the hat off. There's like that. Mr. Tissue Box. There we go. So, more information, just go to WinterConNewYork.com, for dealer tables, artist alley tables, panel submissions, all that good stuff. But I wonder if Michael Beans was the one who's in the worst movie of all motherfucking time. I wonder if that's the Michael Beans that was in the worst movie featuring a wrestler of all time, which would be The Marine with John Cena. That movie sucked monkey balls. Do not Netflix it, or your eyes will burn out. It's that bad. John Cena cannot act. I said it. John Cena is the worst crossover pro wrestler actor of all time, and his acting is a vanilla. That's not fair! You know, I like him as a wrestler. I like him when he was in that rap gimmick. But his acting sucks. Yeah, I said it. Ironically enough, when they were casting the Captain America movie, First Avenger, he was up for it at one point. Yeah. Hopefully in the summer I'll get an interview with Nick Foley. Because that would be awesome. But I survived New York Comic Con. It was awesome sauce. But sorry, I guess we're gonna be getting the high pitched awesome sauce today. What's wrong with my voice? I don't know. It's very hoarsed. I just can't pull it off. I'm trying though. I hope I don't have that convention sickness that everyone always gets after a big convention like that. But that's what I know. The Awesome Sauce Comics Network is not a one-man show. There's many people that helped me. You're a blind man's champion, the blind ambassador to the comic book and entertainment industry. Out. And I am very, very happy to have them in my life and in my family. Part of the Awesome Sauce. family. First and foremost, Radia, Miss Radia Silva. Radia, thank you so much. Thank you for dressing up in all the costumes. Sailor Mars, the cat. And wait for Rhode Island, man. We're gonna have you. You're gonna be like seeing eye cat. It's gonna be awesome. Yeah. And then it sounds like my parents are watching something on TV. That's interesting. The 1950s outfit when we had the Back to the Future thing. Now I'm gonna get the Back to the Future in a few minutes. Thank you for being the greatest administrative assistant and partner in crime and a blind guy like me can ask for. Thank you. I hope you're having a good time at your gig. Thank you for all the love, all the encouragement, and all the support of this show. And I can't do this without you. So thank you. I'd like to give a shout out to Mayhew Wolf up in Boston. Mayhew Wolf does a Pokemon podcast. And I will get the information soon. Yeah, I'm gonna get to Miss Silver. I'll get the information, and I'll have Mayhew Wolf on. I'm gonna talk Pokemon. And no, Mayhew Wolf, I did not molest Kristen Ritter's face during the Jessica Jones autographing. I asked her, and I can please say what she looks like with my hands, and she got a little nervous. I'll play the footage when I get to it. Thank you. To my good buddy Nick, I think it's Mr. Mediocrity, it's great meeting you. It's, great knowing you. Can't wait to be up in Boston and Rhode Island in a couple weeks with you. And thanks for being a part of the Awesome Sauce Comics family. Jordan White, all the street team, Nintendo Street Team Boston, Street Team New York. Thank you. Thank you for all that you do. Thank you for all that you did. We're going to be doing some stuff in the near future. And, last but not least, yes, I am eating Cheez-Its and drinking water this episode because I'm still a little shocked or something. I don't know. Sauce. Testify. Testify. Yeah, but it's gonna be a long episode, by the way, I think, but I'll do it until I just don't feel like talking anymore. Until my voice gives out, whatever comes first. Lauren Becker of Comic Store Pop Collectibles. Thank you. Thank you for all your help. And if everyone ever needs like convention exclusives and Awesome Sauce Comics doesn't have them, or Comics, or any type of really awesome collectibles, and Awesome Sauce Comics is out of stock of them, go to Comic Star Pop Collectibles. Tell them that Blind Adam sent you. And, Lauren, thank you. Thank you for all your help at New York Comic Con. I hope you enjoyed us bringing you water. Good luck with selling those Godzillas. And, thanks, man. See you at a convention soon. No, like I said, eBay. When you go to eBay, just in the search engine for stores, type in Comic Star Pop Collectibles. And Laura Becker's got your hookup, baby. Test up.
You stole my cookie. I didn't say you could have my cookie.
Well,
you stole my cookie.
No. Someone stole my daddy's cookie. That's so sad. Bumble. No, but, I'm gonna play something, because this would be old school where I go and get water every so often. You know, before I play my first little clip, I'm gonna play one more song and get something off my chest. So Pepsi Corp, this song is for you. That technology is not our friends. But seriously, why am I trying to get one of the digital recorders to work? Thank you all for an awesome, amazing, wonderful, magical New York Comic Con 2015. Wrong clip. I need it. Dumbass. Ain't that special? Blind Adam back here at the Awesome Sauce Comics Studios with the Awesome Sauce Comics beginning of the New York Comics NYCC wrap-up. Well, the holy grail of all the exclusives that you can only get at New York Comic Con or on eBay, and depending on that, if you put them up right away after you got the damn things, I'll get to that when I get to my what really grinds my gears about New York Comic Con in the next fucking segment. But, Pepsi Perfect on October 21st is going to be releasing the Back to the Future bottles that were in Back to the Future 2 in the 80s cafe. Now, Back to the Future is one of the greatest movie franchises of all time. Testify. You know, and You know, Michael J. Fox, Christopher Lloyd, Claudia Wells, all that good stuff. You know, but, you know, the thing that, you know, and I have fond memories of seeing Back to the Future 1 and 2 in the theater. You know, Grandma took me to see Back to the Future 1. You know, we had pizza afterwards. Ironically enough, that was the first time I ever walked into the official pizzeria of the Awesome Sauce Comics podcast. When they were in their old location back in 85. Yes. I haven't gone to Sal's Pizza Corner for like 30 years. And they're located on 71 West Main Street, Ramsey, New Jersey, 07446, 201-327-8929. Hey, Joey. Miss Silver and I say hello. No, but they're making, Pepsi's making 6,500 of these bottles. And they gave out 1,500 of them at Comic-Con. And whether you went to their Back to the Future panel on a Thursday, or whether you dressed up as Marty McFly, or, you know, we wore the red vest and the checkered shirt and the hat, the sneakers and all that good shit. Or you got to play the video game that was in the 80s cafe. And if you beat the person you won, then you won a Pepsi can. Well, this is it. This is the can. Not taking the labeling off. It's got the original formula in it from 1985 with all the sugar cane, all that good stuff, but this is it. Here we go. Very tempted to drink this right now, but I'm not even gonna toy around with that idea until October 22nd, because they go on sale officially on October 21st. And I would like to have a couple of these to resell. I don't want it to shake up, because just because I did decide to drink it, it isn't kaboom! Kapow! Because I'm sure even without the soda in it, this bottle will still go for mad money on eBay. It's already going, they're already going for like $400 on eBay. Careful, careful, there we go. Put it back in this protectable sleeve. Okay, very good, very good. I think it's rough. Very, very good. But that, my friends, was the holy grail of the exclusives. Things to get this year. Get this new account. Really, really sweet, sweet piece. Yes, I am unprepared today. If you don't like that, get your own goddamn podcast. You know? But that is another thing. I'm going to show you another exclusive in a minute. The one I was able to get the most copies of. You know, but, you know, Back to the Future, number one, comes out from IDW next week, written by Bob Gale. We're going to see the adventures of Marty McFly and Doc. And it's a 6-issue limited series, I believe, written by a series Back to the Future creator, Bob Gale. That's going to be released on comic book stores on October 21st, as well as the Pepsi Perfect, because October 21st is Back to the Future Day. Marty McFly went to 2015, and the date was October 21st. So since it's October 21st, 2015, Back to the Future 1 from IDW, Pepsi Perfect. If you can find them on eBay, there was a comic book given out at the Universal Theme Park. Before Universal Theme Park and the jack-offs through management, because they're straight out of Clown Town, got rid of the Back to the Future ride and repainted that the Simpsons ride. And the DeLorean, they just repainted the DeLorean pink. Like that's original. I mean, like, come on, man. Use your imagination. Imagination for you. You know, but, you know, Back to the Future? But Pepsi. When you guys are at an event, can you be a little fucking nicer, please? I mean, I'm not gonna fault Eric and Matt in Hollywood Cars, because they were just paid to be there with a DeLorean. But Pepsi, you had one of the most disorganized, most rudest exhibits at all New York Comic Con. I mean, Sunday it was like a stampede. We were eventually people just jumped the line, and this is during the competition at 1:30. As Miss Silver and I were going to the Sailor Moon panel, which was closed, and I'm gonna get to that and what really grinds my gears. But Pepsi, you idiots! Should have asked for Starburst too. Yeah. And then you didn't have to be a total jack-off to me and my assistant. Yes, I know Friday I won it. But when we came back Saturday morning, so Miss Silver can get hers, you didn't have to be rude and be like, you guys can't come here. And if you've been coming here every day and eating that fan, well, fuck you. And she needed to get hers. You know, I don't know. New York Comic Con needs to be just a little more organized. Just because you beat San Diego 2015, it doesn't mean that you're at San Diego yet. Best remember that. You know what? Just because I feel like playing it, this is my fault. Okay, you know, I'm gonna play a clip. I'm gonna play the first sound clip from the con. I've been going off on, you know, Back to the Future and Pepsi and thanking people. Let's play a clip from New York Comic Con. That's not gonna work. Yeah, that was Yeah, cast playing, I just want to say, is awesome sauce. Remember, folks, cosplay does not mean consent, but we'll get to that during what grinds my gears as well. I wish I had this whole thing. Alright. We were waiting to get on the shuttle to the Javits Center one more Friday morning, and this is the jam I got. This is all I got, but it's better than nothing. Very pissed off about Ben Affleck being in Superman versus Batman. And I'm gonna play it one more time because it's just classic. Yeah, someone red and raven going crazy over Batman Affleck being a Batman. New York Comic Con on the street, you gotta love it. As I have a few more Cheez-Its.
Thing I'm doing on the side.
Alright, cool. Wow.
And
my friends were just like,
ghost with more vision. I'll go check it out.
Cool.
Yeah, all right, man. Jay, thank you so much.
All right. Nice talking to you.
Flying out of out.
Just do that together. Ah, I'm sorry, we're having an editing question here live. As you know, last week, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 50 came out, and the creators and the voice actors of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Nicktoons were at New York Comic Con. We had Kevin Eastman, Robert Rodriguez, and the entire voice cast. Basically, this is the New York Comic Con exclusive to number 50, which I had signed by the entire cast. You know, beautiful, beautiful. I had that signed. As we testified, issue 50, the final showdown between Shred and Splinter. This is from I got this at the IDW booth. Also picked up a copy of Danger Girl, the new Danger Girl Revolution comic, which tells the origin of Abby Chase, I believe, by J. Scott Campbell. Teenage Mutant Tuna, beautiful artwork. Great story. But basically, it's the final battle between the Foot and the Turtles. And basically, in a second, as I put them back in the bag, I have to go to Zap Comics or Midtown Comics. I need to go to the official comic book store of the Awesome Sauce Comics podcast. Hey, Andrew. Hey, Ted. Hope you're all having a good day down at Midtown. But if you really, really need the best in comic book stores in all of New York City, what you're going to do is you're going to go to the official comic book store of, the Awesome Comics podcast, which is Midtown Comics. They have three locations, one at Grand Central, one at Times Square, one in Fulton Street, www.midtowncomics.com or 212-302-8989. Is it? I know other number. 81. Fuck. www.midtowncomics.com because I can't remember the last three digits of the phone number right now. Son of a bitch. But, Midtown is awesome, and I thank them for all the support. Thank you, Andrew. Thank you, Ted. And I'll be talking to you guys soon. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Testify. But I'm going to play the interview with the voice cast. And I do have some B-roll that I had with a girl online about the Jason David Frank CM Punk fight that's never going to happen because, I don't think Jason Frank could stand to get his ass kicked by CM Punk. And you know what I think? You know what I really think? You know what my thoughts are? As we testify. I think any CM Punk fan can beat any Jason David Frank fan in the ring. So I'm challenging. As a fan of CM Punk, the best in the world, at any comic book convention in the world, It could be New York Comic Con. It could be a Wizard World, since Jason David Frank is at all of them. Yeah. I, a CM Punk fan, challenge to fight any Jason David Frank. Ooh, look at me! I'm a White Ranger! Green Ranger! I think it was a Gold Ranger at one point. You know, he's been everything but a Pink Ranger. You know, that's right, because you're running scared like a little girl from senior, from Phil Brooks, Jason David Frank. Go back to you little Power Rangers and Zoran. CM Punk's the best in the world. He can beat your ass, and I can beat any Jason David Frank fan in the world. Awesome sauce. Now I'm going to play the first big interview of the bunch.
Yeah, she was talking for a long time. do you want the comic made up, Adam, or just sign?
Well, I just sign them, can I please?
Got it.
Thanks, man. Just
no problem,
buddy. Something with charity for me, so.
Oh, that's very sweet of you.
Yeah, I'm trying to raise money for a school for the boys.
Well, you're a good man, pal. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. I'm gonna start. I did what you told me. I started listening to your podcast.
Good. I hope you like it.
I'm loving it. I did a lot of pointers.
Great, pal. Keep it up.
I will.
All right. Thanks, buddy.
And next we have Brandon.
Oh my God.
That's really odd.
I don't know. Myself, so, yeah, so to be able to come into work and say that I've worked on something that I grew up watching, it makes my day.
Yeah, The show that you're on now, you made me a fan of Returnsto.
Okay.
Back to that movie with Patrick Stewart on it, I was like, I'm going to take a break.
There you have it. That is the voice cast, and because I'm an idiot, or I didn't look before I left, I did not edit the two Turtles interviews together, so Saturday's signing, or I got to talk to the writers whose name I forgot, Kevin Eastman and Robert Rodriguez, would be played at another place during the week, but that was awesome. Getting to interact with great slaps like that, just totally amazing.
Stop record cancel button, 10311/10.
I have a few more Cheez-Its. And I think I'm going to do a quick, little rant of what the first thing that grinded my gears at this year's New York Comic Con. And it didn't even happen inside the convention. It happened outside on 10th Avenue. Jesus. Sorry, grab it, almost popped me up top of my mouth hole. So, there was a comic book that was created by another guy whose interview I'll play later called The Sequel to the Bible, The Bible 2. He also did this abortion comic, all sorts of political humor, which is protected by the greatest thing we have in this country called the First Amendment. Which protects us our right to say what we want, do what we want, believe what we want. And that's why you should fucking love America. But you can't say what you want, do what you want. And granted, you can't do stupid stuff like, fire in a car theater. Rosa, you can have your own opinions. You can think what you want. Ah, that's better. I should launch something before I do these. But there's this Christian group outside on 10th Avenue Saturday. And because I was getting stuff signed and meeting Frank Miller and all sorts of other cool stuff, which will play throughout the week, or this show would be 4 hours long, which I don't feel like doing. Maybe I'll do the second episode after dinner, before the other stuff I have to do and all that good shit. But to the Christian group that was protesting outside, please get lives. So it's really, really grinding my gears, and it's really, really, really pissing me off that you hardcore Christian jackasses cannot take a joke. And this is when I think of what Chris Rock said in the movie Dogma. I'd rather have a good idea than a strong belief. Because a good idea can be changed, persuaded. A strong belief can never really be defeated. And it's sad, because if you dumb, self-righteous, sanctimonious, wanting to police everything morons would have walked inside the convention, you'd see more love and more heart and more respect for everyone's fucking fellow man. And you went in your stupid backwater little church. Yeah, I said it. And I believe it was the God Hates America group. Because they have God Hates Fags, God Hates... And they start an offshoot. So I can, email comicpimpvip at gmail or 201-675-2104. I think they may have started something called God Hates Comics. I don't know. I can't confirm that. I was inside getting things signed by Jessica Jones at that point. I was molesting her face, as Moohoo Wolf would say. I molest a lot of girls' faces, but, I can't see with my eyes, so I gotta see with my hands. But that's another story. I'll get that tomorrow, I think. Before you guys start, all you play haters, anyone who wants to protest a comic book convention, you need to get a life. Or come on, buy a ticket, walk in, and see true love. So what I saw all fucking weekend was this. And I wish I had the voice and I wish I was alone in the house to really rant on this way. I would like to rant on it, but I'm not. But if anyone in the church organization, the Million Moms, those twat waffles, can't understand 100,000 people getting together like a fucking family once a year at Jacob Javits Center, where you can have any disability and go there alone and walk out with friends, or just everyone accepts everyone, everyone loves everyone. Granted, there's fights, granted, there's arguments, whatever the fuck. But the comic book convention is the most loving, most caring, most wonderful place in the world, and I'm going to be damned to some religious fanatical scumbags. I'm going to sit there and tell people not to come in. You can go fuck yourselves. There, I said it. Assholes. Look at me. We can preach the Bible. Oh, my God. We can tell people what to believe and what to think. What, 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 what? Fuck you. This is it. This is going to be what people are going to say that I got too far. You I mean, it irritated me. Another thing that irritated me at this year's Comic-Con is the whole CW Warner Brothers wristband situation. When I was going to get my Legends of Tomorrow autographs, and I'm going to play that interview later, but because I'm about to end today's episode because my voice is shot. Linda, hey Linda, how you doing? You know, the nice lady and her husband, Fred, who is before us, as 300 people a flash mob to get the wristbands. They shoved this one lady to the floor, like I can talk, and banged up her knee pretty good where she had to get ice. Now, this is a fucking convention. There's no need for this crap. Okay, do you want to rush to get your wristbands? That's fine. But can you do it organized? Can you be polite about it? You know, it's not the security guards who's watching the line, you know, that you didn't get your wristband. You don't have to take their heads off and yell at them and be assholes about it. You know, you don't have to, like, push. You don't have to shove to get somewhere. Ask politely to move out of the way. 9 times out of 10, it will happen. I mean, it's just insane that, you know, really, really irritated me. And my voice is shot. As always, I thank you all for being a loving and amazing Awesome Sauce family. Always keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the gold. Blind Adam out. Testify.
Cancel button. 11:58/1. Cancel button. Stop recording button. 11:03. Loading icon. 11:09. Stop recording button. Enter.